Since the beginning of human civilization, people have wondered, where are we in the universe? Are there other planets like ours? How big is the universe? To answer these questions, early astronomers have made systematic observations of the sky. From Earth, we see the sun rising in the east every morning and setting in the west in the evening. Ancient people also saw this movement of the sun across the sky and conclude that the entire universe was moving around us. The ancient Greeks were the first to suggest a geocentric view of the universe. According to Plato, the universe was perfect and unchanging. The Earth was a sphere, stationary, at the center of the universe. To Aristotle, the spherical Earth was at the center of the universe, and all the planets and sun were attached to concentric spheres which rotate around the Earth. In the 2nd century AD, the astronomer Claudius Ptolemy wrote the Almagest, his most famous work, where he developed the most comprehensive geocentric model. According to Ptolemy, each planet revolves uniformly along a circular path called epicycle, the center of which revolves around Earth along a larger circular path called circumferent. The epicycle center sweeps out equal angles along the circumference in equal times from a point that he called the equant. The center of the circumference was located midway between the equant and Earth. Using epicycles, circumference, and equants, Ptolemy tried to explain the motions of the planets. His explanation was widely accepted. The geocentric theory. First, let's see what geocentric means. The word geocentric comes from the Greek roots geo, meaning earth, centrikos, meaning at the center. The earth at the center. Ptolemy placed the earth at the center of his geocentric model. He believed that the Moon was orbiting on a sphere closest to the Earth, followed by Mercury, then Venus, and then the Sun. Beyond the Sun were a further three spheres when Mars, Jupiter, and then Saturn orbited the Earth. It was necessary for planetary orbits to be perfectly circular, as this reflected what was considered the perfection of creation. The geocentric theory was accepted by the Catholic Church, especially because it coincided with the biblical text that placed man as the central figure of divine creation. The Church taught that God put Earth at the center of the universe, which made Earth special and powerful. However, the geocentric model couldn't explain the retrograde motion and the changes in brightness of the planets. So astronomers tried to fit their observations to the theory, making this model increasingly complicated. Despite the complexity of the model, the geocentric theory prevailed for over 1,000 years. It wasn't until the 16th century that Polish astronomer Nicolaus Copernicus challenged the geocentric model and proposed the heliocentric model of the universe. He believed that the Sun was the real central point of the universe. Copernicus claimed that Earth revolves the Sun, not the other way around. The heliocentric theory. First, let's see what heliocentric means. The word heliocentric comes from the Greek roots helio, meaning sun, and centrikos, meaning at the center. The sun at the center. The heliocentric model positioned the sun at the center of the universe, with Earth and other planets orbiting around the Sun. The planets were in the following order from the Sun. Mercury was in a circular orbit closest to the Sun. Venus, a little further out. The Earth was the third planet from the Sun, and the Moon is in orbit around the Earth, not the Sun. Then, Mars. Beyond that, Jupiter and Saturn. At that time, only 6 planets were known. Uranus and Neptune were discovered years later. According to the heliocentric model, Earth revolves around the Sun, and Earth rotates on its own axis. As Earth rotates, it seems like the Sun is moving across the sky, but it's really the Earth that is spinning. Retrograde motion is an optical illusion caused by Earth overtaking an outer planet that makes a planet appear to be moving backwards. Unfortunately, Copernicus couldn't find enough evidence to support the heliocentric theory. The Italian astronomer Galileo Galilei defended the heliocentric theory of Copernicus. Based on his astronomical observations, he provides evidence to prove this theory. Around the year 1609, Galileo built his own telescope and began to make remarkable discoveries. He could see some stars that no one else had seen before. Galileo was able to see the Moon in great detail. He discovered that the surface of the Moon is not smooth and uniform, but is uneven and rough, full of mountains and valleys, like Earth. He even tried to calculate the height of some of those mountains. Galileo also discovered 4 large moons orbiting Jupiter, and they are now known as the Galilean satellites, in his honor. These discoveries provide strong evidence that most celestial bodies did not revolve around the Earth. Galileo saw dark spots moving across the Sun's surface and concluded that the Sun was moving, and the sunspots are carried along in this rotation. Galileo found that Venus went through phases, just like our Moon. When Venus is full, it appears smaller, and when Venus's crescent, it appears big. The change in size implies that the distance between Earth and Venus is changing. This fact led to the conclusion that Venus revolves around the Sun, rather than Earth. Galileo shared his knowledge in a book called Dialogue Concerning the Two Chief World Systems, where he defended Copernicus' ideas. Galileo's findings brought him into conflict with the Church. This is partly because the Church still taught that the Earth was the center of the universe. Galileo said loudly and clearly that the Sun was the center of the universe, and that Earth and other planets revolved around the Sun. Church officials feared that those scientific ideas could threaten the powerful influence of the Church. Galileo was put on trial. He was found guilty. Galileo was forced to recant his theories and placed under house arrest for the rest of his life. Other scientists provided more evidence to support the heliocentric theory. Kepler discovered that the Earth and planets move around the Sun in elliptical orbits. He also stated that the planets move faster near the Sun and move slowly when they are away from the Sun. Years later, Isaac Newton used Kepler's law of planetary motion to develop his law of universal gravitation. Further discoveries show that the Sun is only the center of our solar system, not the center of the universe. And thanks to advances in science and technology, we also know that Earth and its solar system are part of the Milky Way galaxy, which is one of many galaxies in the universe. For further information about today's lesson, go to cerebralia.com/en. You'll find the link in the description box. Don't forget to share this video and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.